the side of a minor road a few miles from Kilkenny City. A small bush hangs heavy, its boughs weighed by countless colourful rags, each one representing a person who had to emigrate, to leave his home to try to find work. The rags were tied by family members left behind as a symbol of their loss and for luck. Lately, the tree has increased in colour, and its branches hang even closer to the ground. Down this road, nesting on the banks of the King's River, is a small village of Kells. And soon this quiet, sleepy town will explode into life and become the centre of activity for tourists and the curious alike, because Kells is 800 years old. And will be celebrating its birthday in a style more akin to a big city than a small village. 800 years is a long time. Life was totally different. Priorities were weighed on a different scale. Time was slow, and things took time. It was another age, another era, and since then many things have changed. But somehow, this small village's character is rooted in that era. The river, the constant water, has been tapped countless times, providing power and livelihoods as far back as recorded history. Within shouting distance of each other, 11 water mills line a stretch of river a few miles long. Most of them are now in a state of disrepair, but some of them are still in working order, having only ceased operation a short time ago. On a hill near the village, Kilree Round Tower rises up, looking out over the rolling landscape. Nearby, one of the few remaining ancient Celtic crosses sits in a field, a monument to Niall Caillie, High King of Ireland, who drowned in the river below, saving one of his servants. Hence the name of the waterway that runs through Kells. Sitting near the river, sleeping huge stone towers and high walls enclose what was once a thriving self-contained community. This vast ancient building was once the centre of activity for a huge area of Ireland, and now it will be the focus point for the Kells 800 celebrations. Centering around the vast ruins of the Augustinian Priory, which curiously is built more like a fortified castle than a place for peaceful prayer and meditation, the celebrations will take place over 10 days between the 9th of July, when a grand parade of pageantry and colour will mark the commencement of the celebrations, and the 18th of July, when the festival closes. The village of Kells will be recreated to its former medieval splendour. This whole area will be lined with colourful stalls, street entertainment, including live music, and the hullabaloo that you would associate with a thriving medieval village. An ecumenical service will be held here in the Priory on the 11th of July to commemorate the coming of the Augustinian canons regular from Cornwall. A medieval pageant incorporating a real wedding, commemorating the marriage of Strongbow's sister, Eva, to the Baron Geoffrey Fitzrobert will be held, culminating in a huge communal medieval wedding feast. Like a miniature rehearsal of the events to come, the village rallied together and entered the floating St. Patrick's Day parade in Kilkenny to announce to all, like an ancient herald, the coming of a great event. So proud were the people of Kells of their mobile advertisement that they held a few weeks later a second parade in their own village. Everybody was there, even the High King himself. Old and young, everybody working together for a common cause. This is a people lifting themselves up, latching onto their history and finding inspiration and energy from it, to announce their presence and to celebrate both the ancient past and the hopeful future. A future where the rag tree will be stripped bare of its burden of cloth and its branches allowed to climb high again.